Hello everybody, my name is Jonas Lüdefink and I will give a short introduction to our paper Self-Supervised Domain Mismatch Estimation for Autonomous Perception. Here you can see the head of our paper with all the associated authors, which is me, Justin Ferling, Marvin Klingner and my supervisor Professor Tim Fingscheid from Technische Universität Braunschweig, Institute for Communications Technology, as well as Fabian Hüger, Peter Schlicht and Nico Schmidt from Volkswagen Group Automation. Semantic segmentation is a common perception function in autonomous driving, which takes an image and produces a semantic segmentation prediction which can be evaluated with the ground truth via the mean intersection of a union. We use a self-supervised autoencoder to reconstruct the input image. This can be evaluated via the PSNR without the need of labels. Afterwards, we use the PSNR to predict the performance of the semantic segmentation without the need of labels. Let's have a closer look at our domain mismatch estimation. Here we have our autoencoder, which is trained with a variety of loss functions and evaluated with the PSNR. We can compute the histogram of PSNRs in the training as well as in the inference. Afterwards, we compare these two distributions via the Earth Mover's distance, which is also called Wasserstein 1 distance, to obtain our domain mismatch metric. To simulate the domain shift, we use three different data sets, namely Cityscapes, Kitty, and Berkeley Deep Drive. As you can already see, these datasets differ not only in image size, but also in image content, as for example Cityscapes has mostly urban scenes, while Berkeley Deep Drive, for example, also consists of highway scenes. Evaluating an autoencoder trained on Cityscapes on the Cityscapes train dataset, of course, yields a very smooth distribution, as we can see here on the left. This is our training and reference distribution for the Earth Mover's distance later. This is different if we evaluate other data sets as Cityscapes validation, Berkeley Deep Drive validation and the Kitty train set. Here we can see that we have major differences in the mean and the variance of the distributions, which are due to the domain shift. On this slide, we can see the results for the autoencoder trained on Cityscapes. We divide our results into two sections, the absolute ones, which are the PSNR for the autoencoder and the MIU for the segmentation, and the relative ones, which are our domain mismatch metric for the autoencoder and the delta MIU for the segmentation. Of course, the domain shift is lowest between the training and validation set of Cityscapes, but also for the other data sets we can see a similar trend, meaning that if the MIU is dropping, also the PSNR of the autoencoder is dropping. To quantify this effect, we also computed the Kendall's rank order coefficient tau, which shows us a very good rank order correlation between the PSNR and the MIU, as well as between the domain mismatch metric and the delta MIU. This shows that both of these metrics are well suited for observation, but our proposed domain mismatch metric has the advantage that we can define a threshold for an acceptable domain shift. Let me conclude my talk. We propose a framework to monitor the performance of a black box module, namely a semantic segmentation, by an autoencoder which is trained in a self-supervised fashion. By this, we can define our domain mismatch metric with the Earth Mover's distance, which is also called Wasserstein 1 distance. This domain mismatch metric yields a very strong rank order correlation between the domain mismatch and the delta MIU. Thank you for watching. Check our paper.